Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So this is my fall favorites video. If you watched my summer favorites and must-haves video, you know that I usually have way too many ideas for tutorials and things of that nature to be able to film a monthly favorites. I just can't seem to squeeze it into my schedule. So I like to do a seasonal favorites. So I live in California, I live in the Central Valley, and it's usually pretty hot here for the most part. We usually get about 2 months of cold weather during the entire year, which is ideal for me. I don't really like cold weather. The only thing that I like about the cold weather is the fashion. I love hats and scarves and gloves and pea coats and boots. So the first thing on my fall favorites is this shirt I am wearing right now. This is from American Eagle and it is called, I think, the Vintage Plush Tee. And it is like the softest material ever. It feels like when you buy a brand new hoodie and the inside is really super soft and fleecy, that's what it feels like all over. So I love it so much. I got several of these and I love this one the most because it says, live your life. And that's my motto, girl. The next fashion item that I want to share with you that has been one of my favorites is this Betsy Johnson Infinity Scarf. And you can see it is this light gray and it has little pearls all over it. So it's super duper girly and it is just an infinity scarf. So it's one of these ones that's just a circle. I prefer infinity scarves because they are just no fuss. You just put it on and you don't have to worry about like tying it a certain way. You just throw it on and you're good. And this one is like a cable knit, so it's super duper warm. It's gonna last me all hour long. It's a gray, so you can't tell when it's dirty. So obviously it's super cute and you can tell why it's one of my favorites. One of my favorite things about the holidays is the food. I'm not going to show you a ton of food on camera. I think that's kind of silly, but I love holiday food, Thanksgiving food, Christmas food, mashed potatoes, everything. I get festively plump pretty much every year, so food is definitely on my list year round, but holiday food, it's just like, it's all comfort food. Another thing I love about food during the holiday season is that you can get peppermint candy pretty much everywhere you turn. These Hershey's candy cane candies, it's just like white chocolate with candy cane pieces in it. It's so good. The next products that I just have to give a shout out to are the two skincare products that completely improve my skin. The first is the First Aid Beauty Skin Rescue Deep Cleanser. This is with red clay and the fresh sea berry oil. I just put up a skincare video. My last video is all about these two products and how they improve my skin. I will link that down below so you can see why these completely changed my skin. I will be ever thankful for these two products. Next up, of course, as always, I have makeup products to show you. My first favorite makeup product for the season is the Hourglass Mineral Veil Primer, and this goes underneath your foundation. This is the smaller size. I tend to get smaller sizes if I don't know if I'm gonna like a product and it's kind of on the pricey side. So I think this was about $18 for the smaller size. You can get the full size version, which I believe is $52. And after going through almost all of this product right here, I can tell you that I will be buying the full size version. This primer is the best one I've ever used. It keeps your foundation looking fresh and freshly applied for hours and hours and hours and hours and hours. Regardless of whether you're sweating or you're oily or you're dry, no matter what, this makes it look just so fresh and beautiful. So definitely on my favorites. Definitely, even though it is a little on the pricey side, it is well worth it. Another thing is you can use this underneath any type of foundation. It doesn't matter if it is drugstore, high-end, a matte finish, dewy finish, no matter what. This is going to keep it looking exactly the way that it did when you applied it. Now, if you've been watching my recent tutorials, you probably know that my favorite foundation as of recent is the YSL Fusion Ink Foundation. This is a matte foundation. It is formulated for all skin types, but it works great, wonderful, perfectly for oily skin because it stays matte for 24 hours. I don't know many people that want to leave their foundation on for 24 hours and have it look great the entire time, but it will do it if that's what you want it to do. I do have a review for this foundation so you can see me apply it and you can see it on my skin. I'm not wearing it today, I'm just wearing L'Oreal True Match today. But if you want to see how this looks, I will link that down below for you so you can check out that video. I think it's only like a 4-minute video, so it's really short. So it's perfect and I love it. My next favorite is a highlighter. It is the Bobbi Brown Shimmer Brick and this is in the color Sandstone. And this was actually a gift from one of my girlfriends. She bought it and realized it was too glittery for her taste. So she asked me if I wanted to have it and I said, hell yes I do. Bobbi Brown Shimmer Bricks are amazing. They have so many different colors and you can use one end of the product for a lighter color. You can use the other end of a product for a completely different color. They have different versions at different stores. Sometimes they'll have some at like Nordstrom that you cannot get at Sephora and vice versa. So if there's one that you want, you really have to look and these do tend to sell out. Here is a swatch of the Sandstone Shimmer Brick. You can see in some lighting, like lower lighting, it'll get a little bit more bronzy. And as the light hits it and reflects off, it's very shimmery. Also, I love the packaging on this. Look at this. It's like this marbled, swirly, just gorgeous. It's not just the standard black with the Bobbi Brown writing in white. She's been doing a lot of different things with the front of her shimmer bricks recently, so I love it. So there it is, beautiful. Next up, I have a pair of false lashes that I've been loving all month long. These are the House of Lashes in Iconic. Now, House of Lashes, they use real human hair. So these are not mink lashes, they are human hair, but they're still very soft. The only thing that I don't really care for with these is I feel like they're kind of difficult to apply compared to other lashes that I've used. I feel like when you put them on your eye, you really have to hold the corners down until the glue dries, otherwise the corners are gonna pop up. So I don't know if that's just because of the shape of my eye. I don't know if other people have that problem, but that's the only thing that I've experienced, but it's well worth it to get these lashes on because they are so beautiful. These are formulated for more dramatic look, and so if you're just looking for like a natural-ish false lash, then these are not for you. But if you want a night out look or a date night look or anything of that nature, then these are perfect. Here are a couple pictures of me wearing these lashes. As you can see, they cannot pass for real lashes. They are way too long and dramatic, but they are gorgeous. Because they're human hair, they're not quite as delicate as mink lashes, and they really hold their shape. That's another thing I like about these lashes, is I'm kind of wild and crazy, and sometimes my lashes will tend to lose shape after wearing them a couple times. I've worn these multiple times, and they've kept their original shape the entire time. If you're involved in the beauty community at all, then you probably saw my next favorite coming from a mile away. I have the Anastasia Beverly Hills single eyeshadows, and I ordered 8 of them, and they come in this 8-well palette. When you order 8 of them, these totally live up to the hype. I am loving these. I've been wearing them every single day since I got them. The colors that I got are Bling, A Touch of Lilac, Metal, Dusty Rose, Birkin, Fawn, Electro, and Rosette. I got some sparkly shades, some matte shades, some transition shades, which are these two down here primarily. And this shade right here, A Touch of Lilac, is beautiful as just a lid color. You can wear that with or without a transition shade on the lid and it's gonna look absolutely beautiful for any look. This shade right here, Birkin, this is really close to MAC Soft Brown, which is one of my usual go-to transition shades. This color Fawn is just pretty much the same thing, it's just a different tone, it's just slightly darker. This color right here is Electro. It looks just like a solid light purple, but when you apply it, once you have it on, if you rub it back and forth just a little bit with a flat brush, it has a blue iridescence that will come out when you rub it back and forth with your brush. And so it's really beautiful for like on the inner eye area, which is what I am wearing today. You can see right here, I have a little bit of Electro on the inner corners, and it's just for a pop of color, and it's iridescent, so it's very fun and flirty and a little bit glamorous. So the other shades that I got, Metal, this is one of the metallic shades, I believe they're called. It's extremely, extremely sparkly, extremely shiny, and you spray it with Fix Plus or put eye drops on your brush and it will make it even more metallic. And then this color right here, Rosette, is a shimmery deep purple color. Ever since I learned that these colors were coming out individually, I knew that I would want them all. In due time, I will have them all, of course, but I'm trying to be reasonable and just start out with the first 8. I have 4 Anastasia palettes that she had come out with in the past that were limited edition, so I knew that I was gonna love her shadows. I've used her palettes in multiple tutorials in the past, and the shadows are just creamy and pigmented and wonderful. everything that she puts out is awesome, so I knew I was gonna love these shadows. My next fall favorite is the ColourPop Lippy Sticks, and I only got these the other day, but I knew as soon as I started swatching them on my hands that they were going to be a monthly favorite. These formulas are so pigmented and creamy. They feel like a lip balm on your lips, and they still give you so much color, even though they're shiny. Even the matte one is kind of shiny, but they just put out so much color on your lips. The color payoff is incredible. Another thing I like about ColourPop is their colors are so unique. I feel like with most brands, you can just go from one brand to another and they're gonna have mostly the same lip colors. It's really hard to find unique colors anymore. So I was really excited to try these because the colors are unlike anything that I have seen recently with any other brand. So I got four different colors and I'm gonna go ahead and swatch them here for you. This first color right here is called Grind, and it is a matte shade, and it, as you can see, is a purple. This is the next color. It is called Brills, and this is actually what I'm wearing on my lips right now. You can see it's a bright lavender color. So you can see I have Brills on my lips right now. I just feel like it really complemented the Electro eyeshadow that I have on my inner corners. Next up, we have the color Button, which is a corally orange, and it is a satin formula. And lastly, this is the color Bound. And out of the four lippy sticks that I got, this one is my favorite color. I'm going to show you a picture here of me wearing this. It is the most perfect pinky nude, baby pink-ish color I have ever used in my life. I normally do not look good in baby pink colors. They just have never flattered my skin, no matter how tan or how fair I am. It's just not something that's looked good on me until now. Next up for my favorites, I have a couple brushes that I want to show you, and these are all completely affordable. I don't care who you are, anybody can afford these brushes. First up, the e.l.f. Stippling Brush. And you can see this is a small duo fiber brush, and it is a synthetic hair. This brush is $3 at Target. You need this brush. I've been using this brush for everything. I've been using it from contouring to highlighting to setting my under eye concealer with a powder. This brush is multi-purpose, it's $3 and it works amazingly. You need it. I have three of them. Next up for my favorite brushes, I have a Sonia Kashuk brush. This is the number 109 and this is $5.99 at Target. It's synthetic, it's soft, it's fluffy, it's dense, but not too dense. Not so dense that you're gonna get too much color all at once. This is just the perfect brush. I've been using this almost every single day in my crease, and I already bought another one. I love this brush. It is affordable, it's soft, it's just everything that I want in a blending brush. Recently, I went to the Morphe Brushes store in Burbank, and I picked up a bunch of brushes and some eyeshadows, and I want to show you my three favorite Morphe brushes that I've used so far. I've not had an opportunity to use all the brushes yet, but of the ones that I have used so far, I want to show you. The first brush I want to show you is the Morphe MB24, and this is the perfect brush for getting a cut crease because it's a soft, fluffy blending brush, but it has this pointed tip, so you can blend like this back and forth in your crease, and this pointed tip is going to keep that shadow from going onto your lid. This is an incredibly soft brush. It is like unbelievably soft. It feels like cashmere or something. So I've been loving this brush for the crease, and it also works really well for blending under the lower lash line. The next Morphe brush I've been loving is the M433. This is a dupe for the MAC 217. Some people say that the Sigma E25 is a dupe for the MAC 217, but it's not. It's the hairs are longer and it's less dense and it's less firm. This is a dupe for the MAC 217. So if you want that MAC brush, which I think is like $30, $32 or something like that, get this. It's only a couple dollars. I don't remember exactly how much, but I'll link this brush down below for you. So if you do want to go look, you can click on that link below. But this brush is perfect for getting precisely in that crease. Next up is the Morphe M335 brush. And this is a duo fiber brush. I have been using this for applying my concealer underneath my eyes. Normally I'll use a big fat Sigma brush for doing that, but this I just feel like is more practical because it's smaller and it's easier to get more precisely in like under your lower lash line and in that inner corner without this big brush just slamming me in the eyeball over and over. So I've been loving this brush and it hasn't shed at all. None of the Morphe brushes have shed a single hair since I've got them. Even when I washed them, they didn't shed. So I love this brush, and this would also be really good for applying like a cream shadow or an eyeshadow base on the lid. These types of brushes are ideal for that. So I have been loving this brush as well. All right, guys, we're almost there. We're almost to the end. The final products that I want to show you are from Noumi. If you don't know what Noumi is, they make glorious curling wands and straightening irons and shampoo and conditioner, hair products, and they are phenomenal. This is the very first Noumi product I ever bought. It is a 19 millimeter curling wand. This thing heats up immediately. It creates the most perfect curls ever. You can make tight curls with it, or you can curl your hair, brush it out. It makes perfect, loose, voluminous waves. I also have the pearl wand, which looks kind of goofy, but I also have this pearl, I also have this wand with the different sizes down the wand. It makes different sizes of curls down your hair, so this is great for making texturized curls. If you guys would like to see a video of me showing you how to curl your hair with this wand, just let me know in the comments below, or just like this video, and I would be happy to do a tutorial. I did do a tutorial already with this wand, so I will link that below for you if you would like to see how this one works. One of my favorite things about these wands is they are ergonomic, so you can just turn these around over and over and over, and the cord is never going to wrap around itself. It's never going to wrap around your arm. I'm one of the clumsiest people on the planet, so the last thing I need is getting wrapped up in a cord for something that's 450 degrees. They heat your hair from the inside out, and so there's less damage to your hair. You don't have to hold it on the wand for hardly any time at all. Not to mention, your curls last literally for days. My curls, normally when I use a regular curling iron, will fall flat within a couple hours. I just have naturally very limp hair, which is very, very sad for me. But whenever I use a Noumi wand, my curls last for days. They last until I wash them out. I also have Noumi flat irons. This is the Silhouette. I've referred a lot of friends and family to Noumi, and everybody has been completely 100% satisfied. When you do your hair at home, it just makes it look like you just stepped out of a salon. It's unbelievable. I do have Noumi coupon codes. I will leave them in the description box for you down below. So if you are interested in getting one of these products or seeing what other products Noumi offers, go ahead and click the link that I have below for Noumi to go to the website, and I will also show you down below what coupon codes I have for different items. So do not pay full price for one of these. They are very, very pricey as far as hot tools are concerned. So make sure you use a coupon code. Do not pay full price for these. So that's gonna do it for my fall favorites video, you guys. I hope you enjoyed. If you did like this video, don't forget to click like down below, and don't forget to click subscribe. You can click the subscribe button, or you can click somewhere around here. If there's any sort of video that you'd like to see me post in the future, go ahead and leave that in the comments below, and I would be happy to consider that. I just want to say it's not always easy being a small YouTube channel, just keeping up on makeup trends and keeping up on my makeup collection for no pay. It's not always easy being that small YouTube channel, but the things that you guys say to me, your encouraging words and your compliments to me, they keep me going, they keep this channel going, and it makes me want to get better and better every day. So I thank you guys so much for all of your support. My channel has grown so much recently, and I know it's because of you guys and your liking and sharing and subscribing, and I just can't thank you enough. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and if you'd like, you can email me and we can be internet friends, and I would be happy to chat with you. So thank you so much for watching, you guys. I'll see you next time. Bye!